So I bought this 3-horse slant gooseneck trailer with the intentions of fixing it up, making a little weekender out of the front, and either renting it out or selling it, make a little profit on it. It had lights already around it. It had on the rear, it had these round taillights, which they worked, but I didn't really like the look of them. And I decided to upgrade to the oval LED style. So I've gotten 3 of them done already. Last night, my drill battery died, so I couldn't get the 4th one done. So I'm back today to get this 4th one knocked out. I have added, let me go back over here. I have added a switch to the side, which lights up the LEDs on the ceiling. And I've got 2 sets of LEDs on the ceiling. That gray color is what I'm gonna end up painting the whole trailer. I'm getting rid of this blue. But it's nice, when I hit the unlock button on my truck, when I come back in after a ride at night, I can hit the unlock button on my truck, which lights up my parking lights. And I've got those inside LEDs attached to the parking light circuit. So I can come back here and flip that switch right there and light up the inside. I'll eventually have like awning lights on each side as well that I'll have a switch out here for. So we can tie our horses up and start untacking them. And I can just hit the unlock button on my truck a couple times and keep the lights on until I can go over there and turn the parking lights on. So just making some handy little upgrades, update, make it nice. I have bought this double bubble foil insulation that I started gluing to the ceiling, and it goes up really well. I used some Loctite power grab adhesive and put that right on the metal. Cut the foil to fit. Cuts real easy with just a box cutter, and I pressed it in there and it went up beautifully and stayed. I've pulled the trailer a couple times since that's been on there, and it stayed no problem. But what I didn't like was I can feel the same temperature against the foil as I can just against the metal. And it hit me that, hey, dummy, you need some air gap for that foil to do any good. So I'm going to strip out these ribs with some wood that I'll eventually then put like barn wood across to dress it all up. And then when I strip out the furring strips, then I'll put this insulation on the furring strips. So the insulation will end up sitting, you know, 1.5 inches or so below that rib. And that'll give me a 2-2.5 inch gap between the insulation and the ceiling of the trailer. And I think that'll really help the insulation factor. And I'll just staple that foil, that double bubble insulation, right to the wood strips. And then I'll put my my barn wood right against that. And I think that'll have a good effect. We'll see, I'll let you know. But we're gonna rearrange the saddle racks, and I'll end up, all of this will be wood when we're done. The floor is gonna come up here in just a minute. And we're gonna put down 3/4 inch Advantech subfloor and then some hardwood over that. Dress it up real nice.